I would like to read out an indictment of the citation and so that the High Commissioner could take the award to him. Dr. Jawad, the senior lecturer in human resource management at Kent Business School, University of Kent. His main academic interest includes gender and diversity in organizations, international HRM, strategic HRM in organizational knowledge. He is PhD in human resource management from Macquarie University, Australia, postgraduate in higher education at the University of Kent, and a master's of international business from the University of Melbourne, Sydney, Australia. In his professional life, Dr. Syed has worked as a manager, researcher, and lecturer in organizations and institutions in various countries, including Australia, Pakistan, and the UK. Dr. Syed has widely written on issues related to business and HRM, including articles in the International Journal of Human Resource Management, Asia Pacific Journal of Management, Human Resource Management Journal, Human Resource Management Review, Management Learning, Women's International Forum, Gender, Work, and Government. In August 2010, Dr. Syed co-founded and became a member of the first working group for the South Asian Academy of Management, a professional association for scholars dedicated to creating and disseminating knowledge about management and organization in South Asia. Dr. Syed has co-edited two books on Professor Mustafa Kremlin, namely Managing Cultural Diversity in Asia, a research campaign, Managing Gender Diversity in Asia, a research campaign. He has also edited a textbook with Professor Robert Kramer. The book is called Human Resource Management in a Global Context, a Critical Approach. I now request His Excellency the High Commissioner of Pakistan to hand over the Sitara-i-Imtiaz to Dr. Jawad Syed.
Equality and anti-discrimination, not only in the society,
kind of thing and still remain ignored. These issues of equality, particularly with respect to equality, particularly with respect to sectarian and religious equality, still remain taboo and substantive steps need to be taken. We have some good things in the past which have been done, but at the same time, they are not sufficient, they are not enough, and we look forward toward a peaceful, prosperous, and equitable Pakistan. Thank you.
The noise you're making and people are doing speeches,
it's not me, much a problem, sorry.
It's a bit surprising that we joined the nation because on the wall, unity, faith, and this is the resistance of greatest emphasis on this part. And the way we are behaving is very unfortunate. We're not listening to your honorable guests, we're not listening to your speakers. Who are paying a big name for themselves and the country. It is very, very outrageous. Please try to behave yourselves, quiet it down, and listen to them properly. Thank you very much.
I now invite request, I shall read out the citations. So Ms. Rabia Bhatti, who has been awarded the Tamgha-i-Imtiaz of Pakistan. Ms. Rabia Bhatti, a 20-year-old British national of Pakistan heritage, has the distinction of being the youngest Muslim female councillor in the United Kingdom. She has been elected during recent local elections. Ms. Bhatti is currently a student of BSc Psychology at the University of London. Prior to her election as a councillor, she was the first president of the Ivory College and was appointed school governor and SEM governor as well. This made her the youngest school governor in Buckinghamshire. Apart from holding the above position, she is also an executive member of the Conservative Muslim Forum and as an executive member executive member of the Pakistan Professional Forum. Ms. Rabia Bhatti is actively involved with the charitable work and is currently associated with MoLBAG, a charity of His Royal Highness Prince of Wales that offers mentoring teams to raise the aspirations of the disaffected young Muslims. Besides, she is an ambassador for the Harsha Foundation, which is an international charity. Ms. Bhatti believes her achievements and her passion, vision and commitment to leadership role may inspire the young generation to believe in themselves. In recognition of her services to the British Pakistani community and her role as a specimen of youth, particularly women empowerment, it is recommended, she has been awarded the Tamgha-i Pakistan civilian. I request the High Commissioner of the National Government to hand over the award to her. And I must point out, she is the daughter of Councillor Bhatti, who is himself an MPA. Thank you very much.
On this auspicious occasion, I would like to extend my gratitude and heartfelt thanks to the government of Pakistan, the Prime Minister and President, for recognizing my achievements and enabling me to share this platform here with you today. I would also like to extend my gratitude to the Pakistan High Commission, to the British government, the UKCCTI, and everybody else who has been an integral part of my journey here today. I wish you all a very good and humble evening. Do enjoy yourself. Thank you.
Thank you. And with this, we conclude the official ceremony of the event, which you're welcome to. And we just enjoy the food here. And then thank you for coming, all of us, from the outside. Thank you.
Rabia, stay there. Rabia. Shoka. Rabia, stay there.